What is the keyword we use to take input to store a variable, to store a value of the variable inside a shell script? No, I mean something like printf and scanf. What is the equivalent of printf? Right echo. What is the equivalent of scanf? Right read. So how do you print a variable?
Echo dollar.
Okay, echo dollar a will print the variable. How to get number of variables?
Dollar hash dollar star.
Okay, how to get the PID of the process?
Dollar at the dollar dollar.
Okay. Fine. So let us see some more scripts. This is a count of the parameters, count of command line arguments. Right. Okay. So let us see another script. So this is a script which prints the 13 number of command line arguments, right? So if I just execute something like fi.sh, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. Is it working as expected?
Yes.
So we are basically printing the all the command line arguments which are given at the command prompt. So let us change something. Is it working? Is it working as expected?
Yes.
We have given ABCD as the 10th, 11th, 12th argument. What is it printed? What is the 10th argument it is printed? What is the argument I have given? See, previously I have given this, it worked. Now I have given ABCD. Still it is giving 10, 11, 12, 13. Right, so is it working as expected?
Yes.
It's not working, right? ABCD, it has to print ABCD. It has printed 10, 11, 12, 13. Right? So it can print only up to 9. After 10, if I just give $10, it prints the $1. which is 1, which is this value, and then it prints 0. So if you want to print the complete thing, we need to give in curly braces. Is it working now? Is it working now? So did you see the difference? The difference is if you just give till 9, it works. But if you want to print from 10th command line argument, you need to enclose in between the curly braces. Otherwise, it will give the first argument and the 0, right? So that's why it was printing 10, because echo dollar 1 was 1, then it was printing 0. So to print 10th argument properly, we need to enclose in between the curly braces. Is this clear? Okay, so I just want to validate the number of arguments given by the user. So let us say I'm writing a script, some data set, which has to print sum of two numbers, right? No, I can't hear you. Are you on mute? Okay, so I want to print sum of two numbers. Am I audible?
Yes.
Okay. So I want to print sum of two numbers, and I give something like, let us say 1, 2, and this will print output as 1 plus 2, that is 3, sum of two numbers. But let us say if the user has by mistake given only one argument, what happens? So there will be some kind of unexpected behavior, right? There will be some syntax error, because we use expr command internally, and if expr we have given only one argument, it will throw error saying that one more argument is expected. So to avoid this kind of things, what do we use? We need to basically validate the number of arguments. Validate number of arguments passed, right? So how do we validate what is the, if you use dollar, it will take whatever you type. Yes, it will take. So while validating the number of arguments, we basically have to check if number of arguments is greater than or equal to 2, go ahead and print sum, right? Else just exit saying a print message. What is that echo? Please enter valid number of argument, right? So how do we do this? How to get the number of arguments? What is the
dollar hash?
Yeah, dollar hash is the expression to get number of arguments. So how do I validate number of arguments printed? So basically we can use something called loops, the decision control loops. What are they? Something like if loop, while loop, and for loop, right? So in case of if, you want to print like this, what is the syntax? So every language has a syntax, right? So in the same way, shell scripting has a syntax. If dollar question mark is greater than 2, then echo, then I'll say simply I print the sum. Sum is equal to, what is the command to print numbers? Expr dollar one plus dollar two, right? And then I'll print it, echo dollar sum. Else I'll simply say echo, please enter valid number of arguments, exit one and fi. So what is the syntax of if is something like this. If then we give a condition here. If the condition is met, it will go to this block, right? And there will be some statements which will be executed, right? And if the condition is not met, it will go to else block. Then we need to close this with fi. So if we need to close with fi. So this is the syntax in shell scripting, right? So if you take any other language like C and all, we have this kind of syntax, right? If and some condition you write, then in the curly braces, if the condition is met, go to this block. Else, if the condition is not met, go to this block. So this is a syntax in C language. So because we know that it is started with this curly brace, it ended with this block. And again, it started with one curly brace and ended with another curly brace, right? So the interpreter knows that where is the loop started, where is the loop ended. In the same way, in shell script, interpreter knows that a loop is started using this syntax, if and then, and then there is something called else. And if the condition is met, it will go to this block. If condition is not met, it will go to else block, and it has to be ended with fi, right? So here fi is something like if is for starting, fi is for ending. This is the syntax. So you need to write the code in between this. So if give some condition, then what do you want to do if the condition is satisfied? Else if the condition is not satisfied, what do you want to do? And end with fi, right? So this is the script which validates number of parameters provided by the users. So let us try this. Is this correct? So here this greater than indicates if you want to compare two numbers, so we have something called greater than GT. If greater than equal to, this is the, so basically some kind of operator which perform some kind of comparison. So if you want to check which number is greater, A is greater than B, B is greater than A, that kind of comparisons you can do using these operators. Okay, GT is greater than, G is greater than or equal to, LE is less than or equal to, LT is less than, EQ is equal to, NE is not equal to. Okay, so why do we need to validate? So let us see that program. So this is the one which actually adds two numbers, right? So let us say I want to add two numbers, 3.sh, 1, 2, it's working. If I only give, what happens? Syntax error. because expression commands expects two number of arguments. I want to avoid this. I want to print a proper message saying that please enter number of proper number of arguments, right? So for that, I want to validate the number of arguments. So the condition is if number of arguments passed by user is greater than or equal to 2, or if, I mean, it's based on your requirement, let us say you are just looking for only 2 arguments, then we can give something like hyphen EQ. If number of arguments is equal to 2, then print the sum, else enter, please enter valid number of arguments. So I'll just execute this. See, I did not enter any number of variables, so it's asking, please enter valid number of arguments. If I ask this one, it is asking, please enter valid number of arguments. If I pass 2 arguments, it is giving the print, right? So this way we can validate the number of arguments, right? Echo dollar sum will print the sum, else please enter valid number of arguments. And this exit is exit from the script with a written code of 2, right? Or you can also say something like sleep. Sleep will wait for 1 minute, 1 second, and it will come back. Okay. Now if I execute 6.sh, see, it will wait for 1 second before it is coming to the prompt. Right. Sleep 5 will sleep for 5 seconds. So this is just for the user to know what is happening, right? So immediately, instead of printing immediately and coming out, we wait for some time before the prompt again appears, right? So let us say, I'll just leave for 2 seconds. This exit one is a written code. So the written code of the script is exit one. Okay. So there is also another important thing. What is it? Something like checking the written code. Written code of a command or script. So how do we check? Let us say I executed ls. I want to make sure that this command is successful. So just to identify which command is failed, which command is passed or failed, right? So what do we do is echo dollar question mark. This will give written code of the command or script, right? Let us say you executed ls. So if you just say echo dollar question mark, it will give 0. So 0 indicates that it is pass. Other than 0 indicates that the command is failed. You can simply say some junk command if you execute, and if you do echo dollar question mark, it will give command not found, 127 error code. Where this will be useful, let us say you are automating something and that task has 100 commands to be executed. So you are writing a script, that script has all these 100 commands. Something like cd mkdir test, then you're doing going to test, etc., right? So let us say this test directory is already existing, and again you are trying to create another directory, it will fail. Right. So in that case, maybe we want to validate whether the command is successful or not. So how do we validate? We validate based on this written code. So let us say I created a directory test. Cannot create a directory, file exists. So inside a script, if I want to automate this, if I want to check whether this command is successful or not, if I execute manually, I can find out, like, based on the error code or error message, I know that this command is not successful. But inside a script, if I'm executing something, there are a lot of commands to be executed and a lot of packages to be installed. In that case, we need to check written code of each command. See, this is one indicating that this command is not successful. If you create some directory which is not existing, and the written code will be success, right? Is this clear? How do we find out written code of a command? How do we check whether a command is successful or not? So let us write a simple script. Check if Return code of a command is zero or not, right? So let us execute a command and check. Let us say ls-lrt, you have executed, and I want to check if this command is successful or not in a automated way. How do we check? The return code of a command is $?=0, then echo command is successful, else echo command is failed, right? Command is successful. So ls-lrt is printed on the screen. This is the output of ls-lrt, and it says command is successful. If you give something else, let us say I give some command which is not existing or which will fail, then it says command is failed. Command is failed, right? Is this clear? So basically we want to check whether a command is successful or not using the return code of the command. So return code is given by $?expression. So if we give echo $?, it checks whether the command is successful or not. Zero indicates success. Other than zero, anything is failure, right? Is it clear? So let us say when we like if condition before or after, what is that? Any? Yeah, you mean the what is the, can we identify based on the error code? Yes, we can identify. So every error code will have a different meaning. 127 indicates that command is not there. So other indicates something like videos, you can check with them, the front desk visual path, okay? So one indicates that the command is failed. So every command will have different written codes. Based on that, we can identify what is the problem, right? Now, there is another thing, right? What is it? Let us say I have this validation basically to check whether command is successful or not. But if you see, this output is also printed on the screen, this error output, right? If you execute it, this error output, this junk characters or whatever is also printed on the screen. Now, I don't want to print this on the screen. I just want the result, whether it is failed or successful. So how do we redirect this, right? So there is a way to redirect the output, right? So okay, so there is an operator called greater than and double greater than. So these are called redirection operators. Right? So this will, so basically output of one command can be redirected to as an input to other file. Let us say, I simply say ls-lrt and then I give a file name. Right, so this command's output, let us say ls-lrt, and if I say file, so there will be a file created with the output from ls-lrt. So output of one command will be redirected as an input to this command. This is called redirection operator, right? So ls-lrt output is redirected to a file, right? So if there is any lsfnlrt file, so it will redirect output of this lsfnlrt command to a file called file. If you open the file, you will have the output of lsfnlrt out. Or if you just say host name and redirect it to this file, let us say file one, you will have output of this command. What is output of this command? Whatever the host name, right? So like this, any command's output can be redirected to a file using greater than operator. If there is no new file, it will create a new file. But if the file is already existing, it will overwrite, right? So now file one has this content. Sorry, if I do echo hi to file, previously the file has this lsfnlrt output, and if I do cat file, this hi is overwritten. So this overwrites the previous output, right? If there is no new file existing, it will create a new file. If there is already file existing with some content, this file will be overwritten, right? So if you don't want to overwrite, and this is called append operator. What is append? Add at the end. So if you want to do again something like, let us say, what is the output of file? Hi. Now again, if I do echo hi and greater than file, if you see the output, this will be appended. Appended means added at the end. This will not be overwritten, but it will add. It will keep on adding at the end. If you type one more, there will be one more hi. So this is called append operator. If there is no new file with the name file, it will create a new file and write the content. And if we have one file, it will append at the end. Yeah, if you want to add the first, then we need to add some combination of we need to use some combination of commands. Directly it's not possible, but if you want to add at the end, double greater than is the command. Okay, so if you say something like hello, so this hello content will be written to the file at the end. Is this clear? Can we show how if possible? What do you mean by that? Okay, you mean adding at the beginning. So that we need to add a combination of some commands like awk and all. That we'll see when we are covering that in the coming classes. Okay. So greater than and double greater than, these are the redirection operator. Greater than will write into a file. If there is no file existing, it will create a new file. If the file is already existing, it will overwrite. If you don't want to overwrite, if you want to add at the end, there is something called append operator, which will add at the end of the file. Okay. So now in this case, in the previous case, we were actually printing the output on the screen. Right, so this command, whatever you give, that output is printed on the screen. Right, so I'm interested only on this result, whether command is successful or not. I don't want to print this. So what we can do is we can redirect this output to some file, so that file will have this content, or we can redirect it to null device. Dev slash null. Okay, so this is basically like redirecting the output to null, so nothing will be stored and you will not have the output on the screen. So now only whether the command is successful or failed, only that will be shown on the screen, right? Let us say I give something and it will not throw the 1 minute. So there is a way to, so this will definitely throw an error message, right? So on the screen. So if it is successful, that content will be returned to dev null, okay, which is command is successful. If command is not successful, that is called error output, right? So that will be, let us see if that it will show the error on the screen or not. So we are redirecting the output of the command to null, and we have executed some command which is not existing. So this should throw one error, but we'll see whether this error will be redirected to dev null or not. Okay, if you just say 7.sh, even though we redirected to dev null, it has actually printed the output on the screen, right? The error message. So to avoid that, there is something called seven.sh is failed. So standard output will be redirected if you use just greater than, and if you also want to redirect the error, the command is to greater than. This will also redirect the error from the command to the null. Is this clear? So there are two redirection operator, one is greater than, another is the double greater than. Greater than will simply redirect to a file. If the file is already existing, it will overwrite. Double greater than will add at the end. And dev null is a output file, which is like a null device. We can redirect whatever we want to it, and it will not store. So all the error messages, all the outputs, we can redirect it to dev null, right? So if this will redirect the output of this command to dev null, and if there is an error, it will again throw on the console. If you also want to redirect the error to dev null, we have to give 2 greater than. This will also redirect error. Okay. Is this clear? Okay. So there is something called while loop. Let us say you want to print 1 to 100. Right, so how do we print? So the syntax is something like this: while and some condition, do, if the condition is met, do this, something, some statements we give, right, and done. So this is like, and we also need to give increment or decrement operator here. So what is this? So something like, let us say we have to initialize a variable value here. There will be 3 things in while loop or for loop. First is initialization, then condition checking, then increment or decrement. So we initialize value of a variable here and we check the condition. If the condition is true, it will go inside and it will execute the statements. Then we need to have something called increment or decrement operator. So based on that, again, it will increment or decrement the variable to some value, and it will loop through the iterations till this condition is failed. So when this condition is true, it will enter the loop. It will iterate through the loop till the condition is false, right? So let us say I'll just initialize I is equal to 0 while dollar I is greater than or less than or equal to or less than 10, do echo dollar I. So I initialize the value of I is equal to 0, then I have a condition, then do block, then I need to have increment or decrement. So how do we perform some arithmetic operation? Dollar I plus 1, then done. So what happens here? So I value will be 0 initially, right? Then condition will be checked. What is it? 0 is less than 10 or not. So this is true, which is 0 is less than 10, right? Then echo dollar I will be printed. What is the value of I? 0, right? Then next, I value will be incremented to 1. So this is the next iteration. What happens now? Now again, it will check 1 is less than 10 or not. Yes, that is also true. So 1 will be printed. So next will go to I equal to 2. Now 2 is less than 10, true or false. Again, this is true. So 2 will be printed. So like that, this loop will iterate till I value becomes 9, right? So 9 is less than 10, true or false. This is also true. So 9 will be printed. Then I value become 10. So 10 is less than 10, true or false. False. So it will exit, right? So 0 to 9 will be printed on the screen. This is the while loop. It has 3 blocks: initialization, condition checking, increment or decrement, right? So let us write the same thing. I value also 0. Then while dollar I less than, let us say 5, do echo dollar I is equal to right. We have initialization, we have condition checking, we have increment or decrement. Now let me execute and see what is happening. Something is wrong with the syntax. It should be here, right? So it has printed 0 to 4. So one more thing is, let us say, how do we debug a shell script? And there is a very big shell script that we are trying to execute, and there is some problem is there, and it's failing. So how to debug, right? So there is something called set-x tag. We can add it to shell script that will actually debug the shell script. Let us say I want to understand what is happening inside, and if I just say set-x, and if I execute the shell script, I++ won't work. That is C syntax, right? If you see, I equal to 0 is assigned, 0 less than 5, 0 is printed. So this is like verbose messages. It will print all the messages on the screen, right? Next expression 0 plus 1, which is I equal to 1. Then I value is compared again with 5. 1 is less than 5, true or false, true. So again, 1 is printed. If you see, you have detailed output here. 0 is printed, 1 is printed, 2 is printed, 3 is printed, 4 is printed. Then 5 less than 5 is false. That's why it is exited. So this way, it will be useful for debugging. If you have a very big shell script and if you want to debug, we can debug using this. Or we can also debug using, we can also execute like this, bash 8.sh, or I can remove that set-x. This also works, dot slash or bash. And if you want to debug bash-vx8.sh, this also works the same way. So if you want to debug, there are two ways. One is put set-x in the script in the beginning, or execute like bash-vx some script, right? This will execute the shell script in debug mode, which will give extra messages and to understand what is happening, where is it failing. So this will be useful, right? So let us say, what happens if I type like this? So this is like an infinite loop. It will never end. right? So if you want to check execution of some command that is repeatedly changing some process, this thing status, we can use this. I mean, instead of typing again and again, we can simply put in a loop with some sleep and then do then the command whatever you want to execute, or some project specific command. Let us say some status, you have some application XYZ and you want to give the status, and done. So this will print the output in an infinite loop. Okay, so this has come out. So this way bash-vx is for debug, v is for verbose, x is for debug. Okay, right? So you can also execute commands on the you can write script on the command line itself, right? Let us say a is equal to 10, so you want to compare b is equal to 20. What is the value of a? 10. What is the value of b? 20. So if dollar a hyphen equal to dollar b, then echo numbers are equal. Else echo numbers are not equal. Fi. So the output is numbers are not equal because a is given as 10, b is given as 20, right? So let us say I is equal to 0 while dollar I is less than 5. Do echo dollar I. I is equal to expr dollar I plus 1. Done. It will print the output on the screen. We have printed from 0 to 4. Let us say I want to print from 5 to 1 in the reverse order. So how do you print? So I'll just initialize I is equal to 5. Then while dollar I is greater than or equal to 5, do echo dollar I. Then I is equal to, so what is the command we need to use here? Expr dollar I. We have to print 5 to 1, so we need to decrement minus 1. Done. What happened? It did not go in loop, is it? I is equal to, let us say, 10. And while dollar I is less than or equal to 0, then do echo dollar I. So for the first time, 10 will be compared with 0. 10 is, sorry, it should be greater than, right? So 10 is greater than 0 or not? Is true. So it will print value of I, which is 10. For the first time, we initialized the value of I equal to 0. Then we are comparing with 0. For the first time, we initialized the value of I equal to 10. 10 is greater than 0 is true. So it will print 10. Then we need to decrement the value. I is equal to expr dollar I minus 1. Then done. Let us try this. So this will print from 10 to 0. Right? So we assigned, so there are three blocks, basically initialization block, condition checking, and the incrementer decrementer. So we can print from 0 to 10 or 10 to 0 using this while loop. So while 10 is greater than 0, how do you want to debug? So if you want to debug also, we can have bash-vx9.sh, which will print in a detailed way, right? You can see here a script editor that I have already, I think, covered in VIM, right? So if you have VIM, VIM is not installed. This will have some kind of color highlighting, right? I is equal to 100. Let us say while $i greater than or equal to 0 to echo $i, right? I is equal to exp or $i minus 1. This has color highlighting. Done. Right? I missed something. Okay, this is not Q, this is 1. So this will print 100 to 0, right? So this is a while loop. So basically we have three things. One is initialization, second is condition checking, third is the increment or decrement. Basically it will iterate through the loop till the condition becomes false. So there is something called for loop as well. So for I in, we can provide a list here, something like 1, 2, 3, 4, then do echo $i, done. So this will list, this will print from the list we have provided, right? So let us say for I in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, do echo $i, done. So this will print all the variables in a list. So this I will iterate through this loop. First it will print 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So based on the list we have given, it will print all the variables from that list. Okay. So there is also another way of using for, which is like C-like syntax. In C we use, right? So same way we can use for. For I is equal to, let us say 0, I. So here the syntax is different from the way we use in shell scripting. This is more like a C syntax. This also works, right? So this will print I value from 0 to 9 because I gave I less than 10. So this is initialization, this is condition checking, this is increment or decrement. So this also works. This has printed 0 to 9. So if I want to print 10 also, what is the change I need to make? So it also has three blocks. One is initialization, the other is the condition checking, the other is the increment or decrement. So if I want to print 10, it has printed 0 to 9. If I want to print 10 also, what is the change I need to make? Yes, less than or equal to. So this will print 10 as well. Let us say I want to print 100 to 0. What is the change I need to make? 100 when I is greater than or equal to 0. Then I minus minus. So this will print 100 to 0 numbers. Okay, so this is for loop. Is this clear? So we'll see functions and some more commands like okay, this we'll see tomorrow. Any questions from today's class? I'll check if I have any of these things, assignments or something. I'll let you know if I have anything. I think I should have some assignments. Okay. So for Linux users, it's already who are working in Linux, that's fine. But for non-Linux users, please practice. Definitely, it's going to be a little tough with a lot of commands and all you need to understand and execute. Okay. Any questions on Vagrant? Yes. Yes, what is the question? So this is my email ID. How to overwrite a file? Date and time in Linux. Overwrite, you mean how to change the date of a okay, so basically let's say something like this, right? You're asking. Yeah, touch. You have a file and this is created at August 23rd 1.sh. now what is the current date of the machine? August 24 1327. So if I just say touch 1.sh, it will change to August 24, 1327. Okay, touch is not only for creating the empty files, it also changes the timestamp to the latest. Okay. So practice all these commands, how to copy a file between two Linux machines, how to check the IP address, hardware architecture, how to go to the directory, how to traverse through directory, because once you join an organization, it will be really difficult for you to, you know, go to someone for small things, right? So how do you change directory, how to execute a file, how to give a permission, so how to check CPU utilization, all these things are really important. Just assume you have got, for Linux users, it's okay. For non-Linux users, if you got a job as a DevOps engineer and you join, and then if you want to, you know, to execute some basic commands, so someone will give something like, he'll give an IP and a username and the password and ask you to connect. Then, you should be in a position to directly download PuTTY or use a terminal and connect using SSH or Telnet or whatever, right? So practice, please practice. We'll meet tomorrow. How to switch between consoles? What do you mean by consoles? Terminal consoles. Terminals. On Linux or Windows? You mean you have tab terminals and you want to switch between tabs or files? I didn't get your question. If you have tab, it's like a control tab that you can switch between the terminals. It depends. You just check the keyboard shortcuts in the options. You can change also based on your listing. Okay. We'll stop here. We'll meet tomorrow. Thank you. Bye-bye.